Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Minister of Environment Dr. Yasmin Fouad said that Egypt's development strategy aims at converting 50% of economic projects into green projects within 3 years. And the minister noted that Egypt started during the last period to take steps towards this goal, as the Ministerial Council has agreed to incorporate environmental sustainability criteria into investment. And the Environment Minister also explained that the Ministry of Finance offered green bonds worth $750 million for the first batch, and also within the framework of President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi's campaign to develop 1,500 villages, the Ministry of Environment began already promoting the use of biogas in the villages, as the President agreed to declare the bioenergy project within the basics of the rural villages project. In order to know more about this very important topic, we're very much delighted to have with us here in the studio Dr. Mohammed Abdel Raouf, energy and environment expert. Thank you very much, Doctor, for being with us. Very good morning to you.
Very good morning to you and to our viewers.
Now, Dr. Abdel Raouf, we would like to talk more about the idea of green projects. Perhaps this idea is not known to many of us, and we would like to know what is meant by green projects and how we are implementing green projects here in Egypt.
Okay. Of course, we have the Vision 2030 in order to achieve a sustainable development. The main tool to achieve sustainable development is to invest in green projects. Mm-hmm. According to President Sisi directives, to shift the economy to a green one, because we have witnessed globally that black economy, traditional one, it's very damaging, polluting, unsustainable, and causes a lot of health and...
Is it called black economy because of the pollution?
Because of the pollution, damage to natural resources. In fact, green economy, black economy focuses mainly, I can say, only on profit. But in order to achieve sustainable development and use the green economy as the main tool, you have to focus on environment, society, and people. So you have profit, you have planet, you have people. You have the three aspects, the economy, the environment, and society. Environmental dimension especially is very important because natural resources are the real wealth of nation. And you have to preserve these natural resources in order to improve the quality of life for current generation, and at the same time improve the quality of life for the future generation. Mm-hmm. In order to do so, there is the government are shifting to a green economy. In the current fiscal year 2021, we have around 30% of the project are greener one. The plan in 3 years is to have 50% of the project as a green project. And this a wide range of project for almost all sectors, agriculture, tourism, energy, sanitation, biogas project, so education, tourism. Mm-hmm. So almost all the sectors can be greener, whether they are service sector or investment sector. And as I mentioned, they achieve a lot of benefits for the macro level and micro level. The most important one is health impact, because we have seen the air pollution causes a lot of health impact for the population, and also damaging natural resources. That's why the country are shifting to a greener technology. Okay. And this at the same time attract a lot of investment. Like you mentioned, it attracts a completely new type of...
This is what I wanted to ask about. You mentioned services projects and investment projects.
Exactly.
If we talk about investment projects,
okay,
how can converting into green projects help in attracting more investments and achieving more investment opportunities or better investment opportunities?
Well, in fact, the future to be in one word, the future will be for anything that is environment friendly and that is smart. This is the future in all fields. So we need to attract a new type of investment, exactly like the Egyptian government issued the green bonds in London stock about 3-4 months ago. And this was the first of its type in North Africa and Middle East. These type of bonds attract completely new investors interested in environmental conservation, climate change, pollution control, and this is related to all sector, not only a specific sector. Because you need to have an eco-friendly tourism, you need to have an eco-friendly financing, you need to have a green technology and energy and sanitation and water and agriculture and so on. So these type of bonds or green ones attract these new investors, open new opportunities, and at the same time they attract new technology. Because all these environment-friendly projects depend on environment-friendly technology in various fields.
Yes. And what is the importance of green bonds in preserving the environment?
Green bonds is very important because in order to preserve the environment, the most important component is the project, especially the private sector, because they are doing the business. Mm. So if they are polluting, damaging the natural resources, everything will go bad. So we need to transfer this project into a greener one in order to have a quality of life for the citizens and for future generation. The most important way to do so is to attract new finance, new type of finance. Mm. This new type of finance also in the Western world, they are very interested in this in financing this type of project. Because of Paris Climate Agreement, climate change, they have to reduce the carbon emission by specific percentages. They can do so any parts of the world. So they can invest in Egypt, in India, in South Africa. Mm. So there is a competition also globally between different countries in order to attract this new type of financing.
Okay. So Dr. Abdurrauf, could you tell us more about the importance of the bioenergy project within the basics of the initiative to develop 1,500 villages launched by President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi?
Yes, in order to upgrade these villages and to have a good quality of life, one of the important component, an environment-friendly aspect also, is to use the biogas. Mm. Well, this achieves a lot of benefits for the macro level and micro level. Of course, environmental protection, water and the soil protection from pollution. You have a small individual units in each village where they are independent. They save a lot of money because they have a clean source of energy. So it has a lot of benefits for the individuals, for the villagers itself. It reduces also the burden on the electricity grid. That is beside the producing different fertilizers. Mm-hmm. So it has a lot of benefits from social aspect and also from environmental aspect. And it raises also the quality of life and the income for these villagers.
And how can we raise awareness for people, for ordinary citizens, to shift into environment-friendly activities?
Yes, it's an important question because we talk a lot, but we need to raise the awareness because we have, like you mentioned, we need the financing and different incentives. We need different legislations and policies. The third component is the awareness.
People.
Yes. Hmm. So we need to transfer the mentalities, especially the younger generation, to instill into their minds natural resources conservation and protection. So it's a continuous process, and it has to engage a lot of actors, media, you know, universities, civil societies, and of course governmental entities. And it has to be a continuous process because, as you see, the problems change. This year we have Corona, next year we don't know what may happen. Mm. You know, different types of technology, different type of pollutants. We have electricity waste. You know, you have to apply different technological environmental solution to deal with different problems that may arise in the future.
Yes.
So it's a continuous process, and at the same time it's an investment opportunity. So when you invest, you come up with a new technique to deal with this. And by the way, it's not only technological in terms of industrial. You can innovate in social system. You can innovate in economic system as well. So you can have a new instrument in economic system that will attract and incentivize different people and different industries in order to act in an environment-friendly way.
Perhaps you mentioned the role of the media and the civil society in raising the awareness of the people, and this is very important because the civil society and governmental organizations are very active in various sectors, in various fields. especially in rural areas,
exactly.
not only urban areas, in rural areas.
Yes.
So it's very important to raise the awareness of the people, because we have been suffering from so many environmental problems, like burning a rice straw, for example, that caused so many health problems. Certain areas in Egypt due to the lack of awareness in regards to environmental issues, practice certain activities that are harmful to themselves, to their health, and to the community, because they damage the environment. So perhaps this is a very important.
Yeah, it's very important, because nothing can happen if the people still do the same attitude. So we need to have responsible.
We need
to have a responsible citizen, you know, who care about the environment, because after all, it comes to himself. You know,
yes.
he can hurt himself.
So embarking on a new era of green projects of
this will help you know, raise the awareness, like ecotourism, for instance.
Yes.
You need after Corona, by the way, the face of tourism will change. So the
yes.
people will
of everything.
Yes, but tourism especially, because we the people would like to go to a quality of life. You know, they can't go to places where they can catch, you know, diseases or polluted areas. And that's why there is a good initiative also by the Ministry of Environment and the Ministry of Tourism about Eco Egypt. So you visit the natural areas, heritage area, when you can learn and also respect these ecotourism and eco places, respect the environmental criteria, and conserve the natural resources. And it also help raise the well-being of local people.
Mm.
But at the same time, like you mentioned, the media plays an important role in order to raise all these important issues. Civil society is very important, because they can fill the gaps. They can reach, you know, remote areas and villages. They speak the same language of these people. So we need to raise the awareness, and it's a continuous process. And we need to use new techniques. So in order to attract people, attract students, attract, you know, individual villagers, we need to use the religious people in order to give a good message also for these people to respect the environment. It's a religious duty, by the way, in order to care about the environment, not to act in an extravagant way, a polluting way. So it's considered a sin in Islamic faith. So and also in Christian faith.
Yes.
Almost all faiths, you know, deal with the environment in a good respect.
Okay.
So it's a continuous process, and as I mentioned, we have different stakeholders, whether governmental institution, media plays an important role, research centers, and civil society, where they can, you know, apply different projects and reach different people in remote areas.
But since we mentioned tourism, Dr. Abdelrauf, it's very important also to mention that here in Egypt, we already have so many places that are eco-friendly.
Exactly.
I've been to a nice camp in Sinai, close to Touba.
Exactly.
In Touba and Nuweiba and this area, they have so many eco-friendly places. Nuba, they have so many eco-friendly ecologists. Fayoum,
exactly.
Siwa. So
yes.
We have so many places in Egypt that are actually promoting, and they attract, due to this particular reason, they attract so many tourists.
Yeah, exactly.
But perhaps now this is a new era where we need the support of the government and the investors. We need more investments in this area.
Exactly. Yes, it's a very important area. As I mentioned, in the future, this is something we have to believe it will happen.
There are certain hotels that are using just candles.
They yes,
no
exactly.
electricity at
yeah.
all. Not even internet.
It's an entertainment process, recreational process, but at
yes.
the same time, it's awareness process about how to respect the natural resources and natural areas. So it's a very cheap, by the way, for the visitors, for the tourists themselves. So and at the same time,
he was a very good example.
Exactly,
they
exactly.
have so many,
and we have a lot of many ecologists, but we need more because. As I mentioned, the old black traditional economic system has proved to be a failure. So
yes.
we need to shift to a new gross model that achieves sustainable development, the development itself, but it has to be green at the same time.
Okay. So how important is the government's tendency to convert cars to run using natural gas instead of fuel and diesel, and the impact of that conversion on the environment?
It goes hand in hand, like the big vision of 2030 is that we need to have a more environment friendly project. So since we now achieved the self-sufficiency in natural gas and started exporting natural gas, and also we are hosting the regional organization for the East Med Natural Gas, East Mediterranean. We have a natural resource that's environment friendly compared to crude oil or diesel solar, especially in cars. In cars, we reduce about 30% of greenhouse gases when we use natural gas in vehicles. At the same time, it has a lot of benefits for the macro level and for the individual itself. The cost of fuel is almost half of the diesel or solar car. Mm. It has a lot of environmental benefits because of the less green gas emission. So it has a lot of benefits, and Egypt has these natural resources. So it's better to use the natural resources locally and in different, not only in cars, but also in houses, in factories, in energy production, and so on. So it goes hand in hand with the big vision of 2030 and how to shift in 3 years, 50% of the project in Egypt to be a green project.
Yes. You mentioned that after Corona, the world will be different, and we have already started shifting into more healthy attitudes, perhaps towards ourselves and towards the environment. So the importance of the project in preserving public health, especially that now people started being more aware that it is very important to take care of our health, especially things that affect the environment, because the first thing that is damaged is the respiratory system. And exactly. This is, yes.
Well, there is a lot of scientists around the globe arguing that most of these pandemic are coming from the polluting activities of different industries, tourism, you know, oil and gas and so on. Because these help to disturb the natural system and release the different pathogens that are stored in the nature. And as a result, they cause these type of pandemics. That's why they are calling now, we had witnessed because of the lockdown in the previous year, that the environment improved a lot, and we have achieved a reduction in greenhouse gas emission, water quality improved, soil quality improved. So we have a lot of environmental benefits because of the lockdown. So it's very easy to shift to this environment-friendly system, especially most of the technologies are there in agriculture field, in energy field, in transportation. We have natural gas vehicles, we have electricity vehicles. So we have a lot of technologies that are environment-friendly and can help reduce greenhouse gas emission and pollution immediately, not after 10 years or 15 mm-hmm. years. By the way, it was planned to expand in this type of technology after 10 years, but Corona helped to speed up the process. Mm-hmm. Because this has a lot of benefits, as I mentioned, not only on macro level or global level, but also for the individual level. Yes. You can work in a factory and you get like $1 million. But mm-hmm. If this factory is polluting and has a lot of greenhouse gas emission, you can catch a lot of respiratory diseases, and you can spend more than $1 million mm-hmm. to curing yourself. Mm-hmm. So it's a balance, and we don't care about the economic benefits itself. No, we need to take care about the environment, society well-being, and employment, but decent, clean employment opportunities. And at the same time, we protect our natural resources. And if we protect our natural resources, we are protecting the wealth of nature, not only for our current generation, but also for our children and future generation. So this natural base can serve the same quality of life for these different generations.
Yes. Dr. Mohammed Abdel Raouf, energy and environment economic expert, thank you very much for being with
thank
us this
so
morning.
Thank you so much.
And ladies and gentlemen, stay tuned. We'll be right back after a short break to discuss some sports events with my colleague Nirmin Abdelrahman, who will be talking about the handball championship that was hosted here in Egypt. And she has some interesting information to share with you, so stay tuned.